So now let's go to this practice. And basically, these are all solvents. Solvents are usually neutral compounds that don't react very much that will help you run a reaction, okay? And what I want to know is there's such thing as apolar solvents and polar solvents. And what that has to do with is if it has a net dipole. If it has a net dipole, we call that a polar solvent. If it has no net dipole, I call that apolar. What I want you guys to do is tell me which of these would be polar, which of these would be apolar, based on the presence of a net dipole. So go ahead and pause the video and try to answer all of these. All right, so this would be apolar. There's no net dipole. B does have a net dipole pulling up, so B would be polar. C is oxygen, and remember that oxygen has these dipoles and it has lone pairs, so this one is also going to be polar. This is a hydrocarbon. It's, you know, it's carbon and hydrogen together. There's no there's no polarity at all. This one would be apolar. And then finally over here, we have a carbon that has a bunch of halogens on it. Remember that halogens are all pretty polar, but they're all of differing strengths. So that means that this F would have like a really big dipole, and then the chlorine would have a little smaller dipole, and the bromine would have the smallest dipole, and then the H just doesn't have a dipole. So would this have a net dipole? Yes, this would be polar because they're not perfectly canceling out, so I know that this is a polar compound. Cool? Does that make sense? These are the kinds of questions that you can expect to get for polarity, dipole moment questions. And what's important to know, I'd say the number one thing people get tricked on is that they don't figure out what the shape of the molecule is first before solving it, okay? So you always have to figure out what's the shape, what's the hybridization, what is the geometry, and then from there you can answer, okay, is this overall polar or is this apolar? Does it have a net dipole or does it not have a net dipole? All right? So I hope that made sense. Let's go ahead and move on.